A federal judge is giving a 10-year-old girl a better chance by getting a life-saving transplant. Sarah Murnaghan's emotional story has gotten national attention. She has cystic fibrosis, and she could die within the matter of a few weeks. But federal rules made her a lower priority for a transplant because of her age. Until today's decision, reported first right here on CNN. Let's go to CNN's Jason Carroll. He's joining us with the latest information. What do we know, Jason?
Well, first of all, I have to tell you, when I spoke to the Murnaghan family, Sarah Murnaghan's mother, when she was in the hospital room, she literally said people in the hospital room were jumping for joy. This is a huge legal victory for Sarah Murnaghan and her entire family and other children like her. Late this afternoon, a federal judge in Pennsylvania ruled in favor of a 10-day temporary restraining order telling the Secretary of Health and Human Services, at least for now, to allow Sarah to be put on the adult donor list. The order basically says in part, and I'll read it to you, it says, it is hereby ordered that the motion for a TRO, temporary restraining order, is granted, and that the secretary shall direct the OPT, that's the Organ Procurement and Transplantation Network, to immediately cease application of the under 12 rule as to Sarah Murnaghan, so that she can be considered for receipt of donated lungs from adults based on the medical severity of her condition as compared to the medical severity of persons over the age of 12. Now, Wolf, this basically means that for the next 10 days, Sarah will compete for a donor lung based on how sick she is, not her age. And as you said earlier, Sarah does have late-stage cystic fibrosis. For the past 18 months, she has been on the donor list for children, but not adults. Her parents say that she will now likely be at the top of the list for adults based on her critical condition and her blood type. All of this comes after the Murnaghans filed a lawsuit earlier today. This in an attempt to prevent Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius from enforcing that policy, which currently prevents children under the age of 12 from being put on adult donor lists. Murnaghan's parents say Sarah and all children should be eligible to be put on the adult list. And in the lawsuit, they say Sebelius had the power to change the guidelines. It was just yesterday that Sebelius said she did not have the authority to make the change. And in fact, yesterday she was questioned about Murnaghan's case during a budget hearing in Washington, D.C. Sebelius told the panel that she could not imagine anything more difficult than what the Murnaghans were going through. She also said there are 40 seriously ill Pennsylvanian adults who are also waiting for transplants. What about them? So Sebelius has said that she has ordered a transplant policy review, but if there were to be any sort of change in that policy, that could take years. So for now, during this 10-day period, the Murnaghans, and for that matter, any other child, Wolf, in the region who is in need of an organ transplant, who comes forward and legally challenges the federal guidelines, they too potentially can be put on the adult list as well during this 10-day period. The Murnaghans say that they just want a fair system, one that can be measured by the severity of a child's illness and not one's age. A very huge legal victory for the Murnaghans and other sick children as well. Wolf?
Jason, stand by, because we're joined on the phone now by Sarah Murnaghan's mother, Janet Murnaghan. Janet, thanks so much. What's your reaction to this decision?
We are just thrilled over here. We are thrilled for Sarah because she's been getting sicker by the day, and we've had two really rough days here, and it's been real stressful. And now we have hope. We have a lot of hope. And you know what? We have another little guy in this hospital who is in the same boat as Sarah. He's not quite as sick, but he's 11 years old, and he was wanting and needing a lobar transplant like Sarah and was in the same position. And now our lawyers are speaking with him, and he should be getting the 10-day under 12 exemption, too. So it's really exciting news over here.
Sarah's 10 years old. Have you told her about this latest development?
Well, she knew a little bit that mom and dad sort of disagreed with some of the rules and about how people were given organs and we were fighting it. And so today she heard that things went the way that mom and dad wanted it to go. So she cheered with us, was very excited. So we had a good moment.
So she was excited. She was happy. Could you give us a little sense of how she reacting, how she's doing?
She's doing good. I mean, she is, overall, she was having actually kind of a hard day. She is, her heart is more involved in the past 2 days. She has pulmonary hypertension that's increasing, and they have done some things to her today that have not put her in the best of mood. So it was sort of a high point in our day, and she said, woo, woo. She was cheering and raising her hands up in bed. I have a little video of that that I can send you over. But, yeah, it was a very exciting day here. Sarah's lung allocation score is a 78. And, you know, lung allocation scores go from 1 to 100, 100 being the highest. 78 puts her in probably the 99th percentile. I haven't looked today, but I would imagine she's number one in the region for her blood type right now.
And just medically, what do the doctors say about putting adult lungs into a 10-year-old's body?
Our doctors here at CHOP say that they have just as good of outcomes, that the surgery is more complicated, but if you have a surgeon who knows what he's doing, it's not a problem, and that Dr. Spray and the surgeons here at CHOP are very capable of this type of surgery, and that their long-term, their two-year survival outcomes are equivalent.
What, you know, obviously the chances right now of her getting a lung transplant are better, but by how much? Give me an assessment of how these next 10 days, how much more likely she potentially could receive a lung transplant as opposed to if she were still barred from receiving adult lungs?
Oh, I think there was no chance in the next 10 days if she was barred. I think there was no chance. I think that we're looking at a 75% chance that she'll get lungs in the next 2 weeks now.
That's a pretty good odds,
yeah,
if you take a look
at
it.
It's a big difference.
Zero versus 75%. Those are pretty significant.
When you triage people based on how sick they are, it makes a lot of good sense. You know, you give it to the sickest people first, and you let the people who can wait, and more people live under a system like that. And OPTN and their system, it has proven that. For the over 12 sets, that since they instituted severity first, more people have lived. And so I don't know why they've left the babies out of the equation, but we're real excited here. We feel like it's a little victory. We're going to keep moving forward. We want this for all kids.
Have you had any direct contact with the Secretary of Health and Human Services, Kathleen Sebelius?
No, yesterday she and I played a little email tag where she kept scheduling meetings with me and canceling them, and never came to anything.
Janet Murnaghan, good luck to you. Good luck to your daughter, Sarah.
And
we'll stay in close touch with you. We're all hoping for the very, very best.
I thank you very much. We are very, very hopeful. Thanks so much.
All right, good luck.